We're here along Deep Creek. That's a tributary of the Nanticoke River in Sussex County, Delaware, and also a prime spawning location for American shad. But throughout the Nanticoke River and her tributaries in Delaware, as well as all of Maryland, the shad fishery is closed. Recently, we met up with a couple of scientists who are working hard to help rebuild the American shad population along the Nanticoke River. Johnny Moore and Chad Betts are gearing up to go fishing. They've got nets, but they're not taking any fishing rods. They're going to be using electricity.
Electrofishing is basically just using electricity to fish for fish and to catch fish. We just use a small amount of electricity, just enough to stun the fish, not kill them, but stun them so we can collect our samples.
Johnny and Chad are with the Delaware Division of Fish and Wildlife, and they are fishing for American shad. We'll get into what they're up to in a little bit, but first let's find out about this electrofishing. The first thing Johnny has done is set up a pump to fill a holding tank for the shad.
And we're just using river water in our transport tank because that's what the fish are in when we shock them up and bring them on board. And we want to try to keep them in as normal condition as possible, normal environment as possible.
Once everything is loaded up and the chandeliers are in place, the guys get going and we're ready to see some electro fishing.
We basically have a netter on their boat whose main job is to essentially net the fish up that's done. And a quick netter can easily just reach in there and grab the fish out of the water. And then we transfer them to a holding tank on our boat.
About the other fish that are not being netted. They are all drawn to the electricity and will be fine in just a minute.
They're never in harm. They're never in any real danger because we use just a low enough amount that it stuns them, though it wouldn't really necessarily hurt them at all.
Here's an American male.
After getting some shad in the boat, it's time to transport them to the transfer tank up on shore. Then it's back to getting some more sample shad. They hustle up to get the shad into the tank, and so far, Johnny and Chad are off to a good start.
A successful day if we have 30 to 40 fish in our transport tank going back. I would classify that as a successful day.
We've seen these guys catching American shad, and now it's time to find out exactly what they're catching them for.